this is the mangled wreckage caused by this morning's crash at one of the busiest rail junctions in Europe. 20 people were hurt, some suffering from neck and back injuries, had to be carried along the track. A fleet of ambulances took the injured to hospital. Some were visibly in pain, others were dazed and confused.
How are you feeling?
Fine, thanks.
Can you explain just what happened?
I don't know what happened.
Excuse me, please. It would
be very difficult. One of Network Southeast's most senior managers was on one of the trains.
From a personal point of view, I was just standing up, packing my briefcase and reaching for my coat when there was a very loud bang, an electrical short circuit outside, and the next thing I knew, the side of the coach was moving. Those people in that compartment moved away from the window. The window shattered, and there was another train very, very close to us indeed.
So what went wrong? A train heading towards Charing Cross left Platform 5 at London Bridge at around 7:30. The other train was heading for the same platform but approaching in the opposite direction when it crashed. It's normal procedure for trains travelling in both directions to cross over junctions and use the same platform. Computerised signals should let drivers know if the path ahead is clear. With the line blocked, tens of thousands of passengers were stuck in rush hour trains.
It was just stop and start all the way, really, from here. From about 7:30, we've just got here about 5 minutes ago.
And it's now 10 o'clock?
Yeah.
So you're 2.5 hours late.
Right, it's just stop and start all the way, really.
Investigations into this morning's crash are continuing. There are two possible causes, human error or some kind of signal or points failure. Rail managers admit this is an accident which could have been much worse and should not have happened. This is Mike Pearce at London Bridge for Thames News.